So, let's just preface this, because we're going to react to something you're aware of, something you've seen before. Let me just ask, how tall are you, Siege?
5'7", 5'8".
Ooh, nice. And Dev, how tall are you?
Same.
Would you consider yourself athletic?
Now?
No.
Now or back in the day?
Back in the day.
In the past, yes.
Yes.
All right, so you're both...
Now, no chance.
You both played sport. What? What was the sport that you think would have impacted your athletic ability with your height?
Basketball.
Did you both play?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Were you a dunker, Siege? Physical man?
Yeah. Me and Siege were Dunkin' Donuts.
And guess what? I still am.
That's what we were dunking.
All right, so...
Unless I could jump on one of the tall guys and they carry me up there. No, I wasn't dunking.
So you two... I love it. You two are the perfect height for this. I'm going to react to a video. I'm just going to send it across. Dev, bring it up.
Here we go with Webb. Webb on the way.
Oh, shit.
That's Spud Webb.
Now, do you see how tiny this person is?
Gets it into Dwayne Farrell. Spud gets it.
Oh, shit.
Brought a smile on Neek's face. He loved it.
To Webb in the open floor. Cool.
Webb finds an opening. Go take one.
He has a lot of heart. I think that's the biggest thing about him. He isn't afraid.
Wow.
And he mixes it up, and you know, he gets bounced around off those big guys and get up and keep going.
Spud would go beyond being an unlikely success story. Playing for the Hawks and the Sacramento Kings, he would become one of the league's steadiest point guards. But perhaps he'll be remembered most for his exploits in the 1986 Slam Dunk Championship, an event usually reserved for...
Look at the height difference. That could have been us, Siege.
You know, no one in the gym, no one watching on TV.
No, me and you were nowhere near as athletic as him.
Big lazy boy chair, think you can win.
Undaunted, Spud would quickly steal the show.
Spud, first attempt.
He would announce to the basketball world,
oh, shit,
that size was no object.
Well, Phil, you get down, I'm leaving.
Mike off the lob and
Rivers. Damn. Yes, come on now. Come on.
Oh my. That's the cherry on the sundae. Our two slam dunk champion with the...
Wow.
I think it was the short shorts.
What, they gave him the ability? The hops?
Yeah. We wore long shorts, Ernie. That's why we couldn't do
it. Yeah, it was that extra .03 grams.
That extra little bit of material and weight of the material stopped me and you from being able to dunk.
I forgot about him, but man, like, you know when you see people dunk? There's a delay when he dunks because he has to go so high up. It's not instant. He's still going on the way up, and then like it's like, you know, sometimes it's like, is he gonna make it?
Yeah.
With me and you, it was easy to say we weren't going to make it.
You remember the old school NBA Jam?
Mm-hmm.
The game, and when they used to dunk on that game, they'd like jump ridiculously high to dunk. Like that's okay. His actual jump. Like that's what it looks like on him. It looks like he's a video game.
Yes.
Going higher than he should be.
Because
he was an athletic freak.
Yeah, he was. But like his dunks on that dunking competition weren't spectacular. But because he was so short, they were spectacular.
Yeah, a lot of his dunks were quite standard dunks. But because of his, the way that the amount of distance he had to cover.
Now, I mean, I'll put it this way. If someone was 6'7" and did those, would you be impressed?
No.
Can I put these in perspective for you?
Yeah.
We all know. Historic basketball player. Well known across the world. I've played many teams. I've played with many people. In my entire time playing, I've had maybe off the top of my head, three people who were better dunkers than me in my basketball career on my teams.
Yeah.
The dunks that he was doing are the limit of the dunks that I could do.
Right.
In terms of given perspective, like where he jumped from to be able to dunk those.
Yeah.
Like it's not like he's taken off right underneath the basket and going up.
Yeah. Yes. That's the one. That was the most impressive one. When he jumped from like the key, outside of the key, and he jumped up, I said, dude, what the... all right. So if I was going to do that and I was doing my layup, I'd run into the wall. There's no way. I'm going straight into the wall. That guy's Spud Webb is unbelievable.
If he tried to jump from his distance,
yeah,
you wouldn't make a layup. It'd still be a shot.
It'd be a running shot.
Yes.
Can I tell you a story, right? Like my uncle is 5'1" or 5'2". He's from Denmark, right? And their game is more about speed and movement because all the cousins and all my uncles and that, they're all about the same height, like 5'5", 5'6". Anyways, there's a bit of movement, getting people around. And anyways, this team came on the court and they were huge, right? They were just smashing them. So my uncle was getting the shits. So one of these guys, I don't know what, but he was bending down and my uncle jumped on his back and dunked the rim.
As I said, I could dunk like your uncle.
It was the best thing ever when he told me the story. But the thing is, right? My thing is, the landing is very, very scary for people of Spud Webb's height. It is, because we used to jump off trolleys. We used to put the trolley side on and then jump at the park so we could dunk it. But once I dunked it, I never used to let go of the ring because I knew it was a long way down. So I had to prep myself to go down because it's a long way down. It's not, it's crazy. I think one of my mates had to bring me down because I hung. He had to hold me by my legs. And then I grabbed him by the head because I was like, man, this is too hard. I'm not doing this shit again. I'm glad I can't dunk. Anyways.